Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to complete the disc scheduling as the last division is CLUK, which we are doing from the past 5 tutorials, guys. Okay, CLUK. CLUK is nothing but circular look. So here we stopped it here and we returned back. So whereas in circular, you'll be going till the end and it is indirectly connected to the initial state, so it will be continuing. So once we are going through the problem, you'll be having a clear idea, guys. Don't worry. So give me a second, I'll be taking a small piece of paper so that we can solve the problem, guys. Okay, just give me a second. Okay, so initially the given question is initially in the state 37, the cylinder. Okay, so this is 50, 100, 150, fine. So at 37 we need to start. From 37 we will be traveling till 53 is fixed. So from 53 we are using circular look. So it will move from only in one direction, or right or left. So let us assume the movement as right itself. So 53, after 53 we are having 98. So 98, mark it neatly, guys, 98. After 98 we are having 122. After 122 we are having 129. After 129 we are not having anything, so we'll be continuing till the end, and we'll be returning back to the whole loop to the initial. So in the initial value we are having 12. After 12 we are having 14, 25, 47. So this is the way of approach which you will be drawing, guys. I'm just giving you an outline, so you need to draw it in this way neatly. That is also not neatly, but you should draw it a bit neatly when compared to mine also. Okay, so you need to draw it in this way, fine. So now once you are done with it, to calculate the seek time, initially you will be writing the order in which you traveled. So you started at 37, you reached 53, then you traveled to 57, then 98, then 122, then directly to 129 also is there. 129, 129 to 12, 12 to 14, 14 to 25, 25 to 47. So now calculate the differences. So I hope everyone remembers that how to calculate 129 and 12. 129, 12. So initially you need to calculate for 129 minus 199. Please remember it is 199, it's not 200. 199 and 0 minus 12. So the final result will be your value for this particular difference. So in that way you will be calculating the seek time. So we got the seek time as 210. So it is best than look, but here we will not be having any starvation, guys. The starvation will be almost reduced here, but the only problem we'll be having is overheads. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this, guys. So in the next tutorial we'll be going through start ride, guys. It's one of the most interesting and easy topic of this chapter. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.